Okay, the pump back here and the cavity, the sump pump for the coolant, this whole area needs a redo, so. So we're gonna do some more restoration on this, but this is where the fluid's coming out. It's gonna go through this little valve so you can control it, and through the rest of this pipe, and then a nice little spreader to come down on your grinder blade, right there. So that's how that end of it's gonna work. And the other end here comes into the pump, and probably not even gonna need this valve here, and we'll just take the hose right to this fitting, or maybe the small one. So there's your full circuit on how the fluids flow, but there's another circuit that comes in here. It's the electrical circuit. So we've got these color-coded so we know how to put it back together. And there's space over here on this side for a gland nut. And so we'll put a nut in there and bring the wires out the side. There's a top that's missing. I'll fabricate a little plate, put that there so we can keep it all neat and tidy like it's supposed to be. And there needs to be a ground wire coming to it. And the other problem, this is an aftermarket pump on an old machine. And the base, it's unbolted now. The base where this goes, the problem with the setup is this face right here. This is too big for that. So I'm gonna have to grind this out. We'll drill some more bolt holes for this so we can mount this rigidly to the machine. That way, even with a ground wire, it'll ground through the machine, but you should definitely preferably have a ground wire instead of the machine. But regardless, you don't want this pump jumping around or anything like that. I don't like those types of setups. So we'll just get it rigidly mounted properly. It's not that hard. We'll just do it right. So that's how the circuit looks. We'll come get a picture of the base. We just used some primer, red oxide primer paint in the sump pump here, in the sump area. And wire it right back up to the circuit, and this is going to be good to go. All right. So this fitting was in the machine. I just cleaned it up. We're going to reuse it. And it's, you can tell it's had a pipe wrench on it before. It's got the teeth marks. Go. Yeah. All right. Now, we have a valve upstairs, so we don't really need one here. Let's see. We don't even really have to use this. We can use this like a nipple. And then just put the hose right here. That would certainly work. Let's do that. Best facility is no facility, so if you don't need it, don't put it in there. Keep it simple. All those things go together. This stuff doesn't come out in the wash very good, so wear your work clothes. All right, let me get a crescent wrench. All right, now we can put it back on the plate, put it on the machine, and then this will be ready to accept the hose and the hose coupling. We'll be all set. Yeah, if you can look in there, you can see where we just took a little bit out from this piece with the grinder manually, keeping it simple. And here's the old bolt pattern, and then here's the new bolt pattern. 1/4-20 bolts. Pretty standard stuff. Yeah, perfect. We're all good. Everything's got an Everseize on it. That's perfect. Now, we'd already put some Everseize on these bolts, so they're ready to go. Get them on there finger tight, and that way you don't have that much to go. There it is. That's not going anywhere. Good enough. Perfect. Get something after that. I'll be right back. And I think we're fine there. I don't think that's coming off, and I don't think it's gonna leak. Either one. Now this door opens up. So you can put on new wheels. And it can scoot forward a little bit. We can always cut it shorter, but it's kind of hard to cut it longer. That's more for slipping than anything. I think our fluid tank is done, and I think the paint's done. Let's put the lid on it. Neato. All right. Let's pour it full of plain old water and do some testing on it. Machine's locked out, tagged out, so we'll hook it back up electrically real quick. All right, these little fittings are really slick, and that's the easy way to do it right there. And I'm not sure that might be long enough, but if it's not, we can get them back apart with this thing. It'll split them right apart. So those two tools are really handy. I've been messing with these forever, kind of the hard way, and it's nice to be able to do it the easy way. So it looks like that's gonna come right down, and our wheel's gonna be right in here. So that's pretty slick. All right, I think I'm gonna open the valve. We're gonna turn on the machine. We'll do a water test. We're gonna get some water in here. We'll come right back. Now, just like we had in front, there's another plug here, and it catches all the water in the sump. It's the drain. So let's come down here. We know it's empty, so I can take this off. No fear. And let's clean those threads up and let's dress it. And then let's just put this one back together. I don't think I'm gonna need this, but let's just see if this is tight. Oh yeah, that's nice and tight. All right, let me dress that up and we'll be right back. Full tank. Yeah. That's just about right. You know, the wheel's gonna be right in here. Bring it in. So depending on what we're doing, that's gonna be plenty of flow. So there's not much left in getting this really buttoned up nicely, but there was no cap on here. Obviously the pump works, we checked it. So I'm just gonna come in here and chase these threads out. They're 832 threads. Nothing crazy, just super easy. All right, now, a little check. Yeah, perfect. It might need to be a little longer to hold our plate, depending on how thick it is. All right, so let's move this out of the way and let's get our gasket maker. So, all we need to do is get the shape of this. So what I'm gonna do here is just hold it steady. And we're trying to get, there they are. See those bolt holes showing up? There. So now we know exactly what our new little bracket looks like. Okay, so this is a cutout from an electrical box, actually. So we're just gonna reuse it, recycle it. And we'll put this right on the back side so it doesn't move around. And all right, you've seen me use this before, hopefully. Now, these don't have to be, they're actually very precise. So we'll drill a hole so the bolts will go through it. So they're through holes. So there's a little slop in them because they're gonna be bigger than the bolt, obviously. But they'll be small enough for the bolt head so it'll fasten nicely. So we just need to cut this out, cut this shape out, and we've got our part. So the ticket now, it just slowly pulling this thing up, one little piece at a time. And I think I'm going to, make it about that big. Maybe take a little bit more of that off. That should be plenty big. So there's the line. Must be some oil on there or something. And same thing over here, put it up, take it down. And these are a little different. I can see where the angle is and where that hole is right there. That's those four holes. The punch made those marks real nice. And then about there. All right, I'll be back. Stainless. Cool. There we go. Done.